As the country continues to deal with the rise of COVID-19 cases, more volunteers come up with solutions to help flatten the curve. Now, our next guests are from a group of architects from the University of the Philippines who developed a vehicle that could ease the testing of COVID-19 in small communities. The Mobile Specimen Collection Unit, or MSCU, aims to collect swab samples from barangays and forward them to the nearest lab for testing. Joining us now to discuss the project is UP Diliman College of Architecture's former Dean, Architect Christopher Espina, and John Ernest Jose, one of the designers of the MSCU. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us this afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Architect Espina, do you mind talking to us about, you know, the background of this MSCU? How did it begin?
The group is composed of hospital design architects taking a graduate course in hospital architecture in UP. They are committed to contribute their expertise in alleviating the problem that we are facing today. So we understand that there are similar groups who are into designing rapid hospital facilities to ease the burden of hospitals testing potential COVID patients and treating those already infected. However, we are going into a different route, and that is of preventing the spread of the virus in an environment where everyone is on quarantine. By ferreting out the possible COVID positives in our communities and hopefully with the help of other groups, bring them to appropriate facilities for quarantining and treatment.
Architect Jose, do you mind talking to us, you know, walking us through the process of the collection of swab samples to shipping it to the labs? How will that work?
So first of all, when we conceived the design for this project, we had three major considerations. So the first consideration was the no contact policy. So when we designed this, we made sure that the staff will not be in physical contact with the patient. So we made sure first that the vehicle is sealed. So second is the alleviation of the load on the medical facilities. So what we wanted to do was to make sure that the patients won't have to go to the laboratory for testing anymore. Mm-hmm. And the third one is what we wanted to do was to create a facility that would be accessible for the people. So that means na because of the lack of public transportation, the people could not will have difficulty in going to these testing centers. You know? So in terms of the procedure, we had three major procedures. So the first would be the screening. So since there are limited testing kits, we cannot test everyone. So we can only test the PUIs and the PUMs. So after the screening for the eligible patients have been made, the next one would be the swab testing, which would take about 10 minutes. So after that, the specimens have already been collected, and this will be forwarded to the nearest laboratory for testing.
Architecture Espina, as architecture, as I mentioned a while ago, staff is a big deal for the implementation of this project. How do you plan on implementing it? Will you be getting volunteers? Will it be health workers? How will that work?
Well, at the moment, we are asking for the approval of the RITM. And so we gave the plans to them already for endorsement to DOH. So once we do this, we are going to look for some suppliers and manufacturers who can do the mobile unit for us. And then, of course, we have to test this on site. So that's what we plan to do.
Architecture Jose, now talk to us about the structure of the vehicle itself. What is it made of? What is inside a vehicle? How big is it?
So when we tried to do the prototype, we only had two major considerations for it. Actually, the one that we've designed is for a specific vehicle, but actually any vehicle can be retrofitted to become a mobile specimen collection unit, provided that it has meet these two criteria. So the first criteria is that it should be tall enough to be able to accommodate a staff inside that is standing up. So it should be higher. It mm-hmm. should have a clearance of around 1.65 meters. And the next one is that the vehicle should be capable of being sealed completely. So for the safety of the healthcare workers. So once the healthcare workers are inside, they really don't have to wear PPE because the the vehicle itself is already sealed. So those two considerations should only be met, and we can retrofit virtually any vehicle for this.
So any vehicle can be transformed into this MSCU. Like, how long will that usually take if it's a normal vehicle?
For a normal vehicle, we're looking at around a week. Hopefully, we can retrofit one vehicle for a week. But of course, it actually depends on the existing vehicle itself. So if the vehicle only has minimum factors to be retrofitted, so the retrofitting can only be minimum. But if the vehicle is vastly different, you know, so it's on a vehicle-to-vehicle basis. So since we are open to any type of vehicle, it would ultimately depend on what type of vehicle would be provided to us.
Okay, architecture, Arki, Espina, we talked about that it's waiting for approval from RITM, and hopefully it does already this week. But, you know, what's the next step after it hopefully gets approved?
Well, the next step is really to build the unit according to the plans and specifications that we need. There are many other things that will have to be put in the unit.
Like?
Ventilation systems, positive and negative pressures, and then also the waste management systems, electricity, and the like. So we already have thought about this, and there are some other consultants aside from us. No, they are engineers who are helping us in designing the mobile unit.
And how much would the total cost of that be? I mean, for the ventilation, the waste management, and electricity, how much would one vehicle cost?
We're sure that it will not be more than $2 million.
Per vehicle?
Per vehicle, yeah. Complete already.
So are you open for any collaborations?
Yes, that's what actually we are looking for. We're looking for, you know, those who can donate this to us, and then who can supply the materials and all that. That's what we want.
Architect Jose, how many vehicles do you hope, you know, what's the goal to have?
Well, our goal is hopefully this can be implemented on the nationwide level.
By when? Hopefully. Like, can you give us a date that you wish, you know, this could start already? Because we have the enhanced community quarantine extended until 2 weeks. So what's the game plan?
Well, our timeline is we're hoping we can have this implemented hopefully by next week.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just waiting for the go signal from DOH to be able to start this project. And after this, we plan to tie up with various LGUs and private entities in order to provide funding and the necessary requirements to have this implemented in every barangay in the Philippines, hopefully.
And how many tests do you hope to accomplish per day with this?
When we tried to calculate the number of tests that the MCU can do, we calculate that it would take about 15 to 20 minutes per test. So in a shift of about 8 hours, I think 32, there are about 32 hours. 32 tests can be done in an 8-hour shift.
And now, as we wrap this up, how can people reach out to you for that collaboration, for the donation? You know, are trying to partner with you in this project?
Well, they can reach us through Facebook. And we're actually trying to create a Facebook page that would allow us to be more open, or that would allow more people to reach us. So there's another way. You can also contact any of us through Facebook.
Okay, thank you so much. The former dean of the College of Architecture of UP De La Man, Architect Christopher Espina, and Architect John Ernest Jose, one of the designers of the MSCU. Thank you so much for your time.